Welcome to the Agent 251 podcast, the real estate show that looks deep into the work and culture at JWRE, Jason Will Real Estate, in Mobile and Baldwin counties. Jason, Agent 251, investigates and spills the beans on his case closing clues and industry secrets for motivating agents while educating buyers and sellers.
Hello, listeners. This is Johnny Gwin, and this is the second episode of the Agent 251 podcast, and I am sitting with Agent 251, Jason Will, and Diana Will. So I've been told you have a wild and crazy Hollywood-like John Grisham story of how JWRE started. Could you please tell us that story of how JWRE began?
Well, we weren't really given a choice. We had started molding our real estate team, which at one time was in the top five of the entire state, but started molding our team to where it was its own brand.
Okay. Team at another company?
Yes.
Okay.
So we were a team within a big brand company, and we named it the Jason Will Real Estate Team and really started pushing the Jason Will Real Estate brand, where I had started out, I kind of wanted to be the guy behind the guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just went to a real estate training, and a really smart guy said, listen, you people in the real estate business or the industry especially want to do business with a name. And so you're kind of hiding behind this, you know, this team name that's it's not like a commodity where people, it's like GE and Ford. It's like the real estate business, it's like they want to do business with John Smith.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, so you need to step out in the light. And once we did that, the results were staggering.
Massive.
We really started to get, just build a recognizable brand.
Mm-hmm.
You know, before we were just kind of a logo and a team name. So we'd had some conversations about that and some conversations about, you know, on a corporate level, what kind of environment and what were the culture gaps that were going on at the current company we were at. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, that's a scary thing, you know, going out on your own,
yeah,
trying to make it on your own, having to assume a lease and all the bills and everything. But our prior company just didn't give us a choice. They kicked us out. They fired us.
Because you're too successful?
We don't really know why.
Okay.
We don't know that, you know, the determining factor as to why, but they made the decision for us.
Yeah.
We were living in Panama, the country.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, one of the things that this company teaches is to hire and leave. You know, you build your brand and then you go do something else. And so that's what we were doing. And so we sold everything that we owned other than a few houses and packed our family into 14 suitcases and put our dog in a crate. And we moved to Panama.
Panama, the country.
The country. We lived on a small island off the Caribbean coast for 3 months. We sold everything for an extended vacation. And then we had to come back, you know, so we had to, we opened Jason Will Real Estate from the country with, you know, technology.
From Panama to Fairhope?
Back to Fairhope.
Back to Fairhope. Goodness gracious.
Yeah, I flew back relatively quickly.
Right, to just start laying down the groundwork.
Yeah,
clean up.
Diana stayed behind with the kids. And
did you buy a house in Panama?
No, we were renting.
Well, that's kind of a blessing a little bit, right?
It's not easy to buy there anyways.
Oh, right,
and so
right,
we knew that we weren't going to do anything that permanent.
The call comes.
We got a call from the CEO that we had appointed for our team. We were in a water taxi going over to a hostel. That was a waterfront hostel, and she was going to sell us like a $1.2 million deal. And we were just about to get there, and I got a call through Facebook. It was our CEO, and she was like, "You need to get back in front of your computer right away. Your licenses have been sent back to the state." So the state board. So panic, you know, really set in. So
it was a holiday weekend. It was a Friday afternoon on a holiday weekend. So everything was closed Monday. So when you don't have a real estate license, you can't make phone calls. You can do nothing. So it was a Friday afternoon, and on Saturday, he got on an airplane
right,
with the full intention of coming back to Panama. He never came back, ever. And so, you know, he was gone. He bought a one-way ticket to come home and just figure it out and pull our team together. You know, they had picked apart our team, too, so which is a steady – it was our income. So on top of us not having licenses, nobody was actually selling. And then they took away – you know, they went after all of our listings. They called – you know, they called all of our clients and made false accusations. And so it was – I mean, it was massive. It was massive casualty.
We had called around to all the other big brokers in town who had courted us at one point and tried to get us to leave and come join them. And we were down to our last guy, our last hope, because they had literally spread so many rumors and trashed our name that nobody would touch us. The guy that we were kind of had our last hope on, he just has a small real estate firm in Fairhope, just a couple agents, but he had always wanted us to come. He's like, anything ever happens, you come on. So he had assured us that everything would be fine, but he called the board and said, hey, I'm looking to do this. Y'all see any problems with the wills? And the people at the board were like, don't touch him with a 10-foot pole. And we didn't hear from him for a while. I was like, there was a sense of urgency. So I was like, please get right back to me and let me know we're going to be okay. And we never heard from him. And I'm trying to get in touch with him. And finally, I got him on the phone. He's like, I'm sorry, I just can't help you. There's just too much heat around you right now. And so that's when, I mean, I bought a plane ticket and headed home the next day. It has put us on this path where we don't have any regrets, and we've been able to change lives. Our lives are totally different.
You now have a company of 70 agents. We gave away some control, and we're put in a bad situation where it puts you like, we would never do that to somebody else.
No.
Because you lived through it. So I have a question. You know, we had a problem with your license. How did you rectify that?
Well, there were no issues with our license. It was all rumors. But honestly, we are still dealing with it today.
Right, because rumors, it doesn't go away overnight. And even when you're right, that stain stays around forever.
It's gone from the consumer side, but our consumer is the agents. And the agents that we want to get in front of, they were in the industry then. And so they have these questions, and they want to sit down, and they want to know what happened. And we're totally transparent. I mean, we'll put it on a podcast. We put it on a Facebook Live video. We'll put it wherever.
I love that.
You know, we believe in telling the truth and telling the story. But, I mean, the rumors were like we were running from the IRS and, I mean, crazy stuff.
Running from the mob,
which apparently is
RESPA violations, federal offense. We were going to jail and we were losing our license. That's what everybody thought.
Right.
Again, this is like Hollywood stuff. This doesn't happen in our nice little community.
They destroyed files so that we wouldn't have legal documentation to go after business that was rightfully ours. they even stole petty cash out of our desk, out of our office that we leased from the company.
They changed all the passwords on our computer so we couldn't get back into any of our stuff. It was crazy. I mean, it is what it is. I carried that with me.
So you go back to Panama.
I never went back. I never go back.
So you say our last hope did not pan out. Then what?
Before he came back to Fairhope, I said, let's just start our own company. If we're going to have to do this anyways, we're going to have to buy signs. We're going to have to do all of this stuff. Let's do it ourselves and never be in this position again.
Right.
His stepdad owns a real estate company in Bay Minette. And so we called him and asked him if he would step in to be our broker until one of us got our license. And he agreed, which was amazing.
That is.
So he had to step down from his company.
Wow.
To come
promote somebody from within to be, to lead his company so that he could come help us out.
That's awesome.
It is awesome. And he's in politics. And, so he really stepped in and helped us. So
he had a lot to lose. I mean, he can't tarnish his reputation. So it took a lot of guts for him to step in because he didn't know what was true or what was false. You know, we're family, but at the same time, he's like,
he had to trust you.
Yeah, he really did. Mm-hmm. And I was like, look, he just asked me, he's like, is anything ever going to come of this? And I said, no.
But I mean, taking a bad situation and turning into what it is, and 3 years, I mean, again, I did not realize, I thought you'd been around longer, but your company's been around 3 years, and taking that very negative.
Well, I tell you, I mean,
beginning and turning into something really, really positive is really great.
We're starting this business in Birmingham. We had a mega agent up there contact us. He knows our stories, read our testimonies on Facebook, and he had similarities up in Birmingham, so we could immediately relate. We immediately connected. There was an immediate bond there. But even people on his team were like, hey, we've heard some stuff.
Really? All the way up in Birmingham?
Yes. So, we're still locally and even, statewide and even because we've done some business over in the New Orleans area. So, there's a lot of people out there. And plus, social media is a crazy platform and really gives you this broad audience. But, so it's really permeated through a lot of different channels. And so it's amazing to us that we're still facing some of these things today. But, we laugh it off today.
It gives us the opportunity to have the conversation. I love now when people ask. I love to be able to tell this story and look at the look on your face and be like, that's crazy. Okay. It is crazy.
It is. Well, and also I did my research a little bit so I didn't come into this cold so I could talk to you. And that was not something that I thought would be part of the conversation.
Right.
So when you tell me, you know, most what I call the spark story, the inspiration story, there could be some things, but nothing to the point of a mass conspiracy against you.
Yeah, and some of the stuff, like, you know, was well-deserved. I mean, because Diana's always been an angel, but I, you know, in my past life, I was kind of an a-hole. So,
who cannot say that?
Right. So, you know, when this friction started happening with our old company, you know, I was pretty arrogant. I was not humble. I was like, you know,
I could see a lot of anger, but there's also a lot of fear there. And you know, when you make somebody desperate, that you don't act in your
best. You get backed up against a wall. You come out clawing.
Well, especially dealing with your family. Right. You were messing with my family and how. And gosh, especially when
that's the exact way I looked at it. I was like, we got kids. Why are they trying to destroy
us? But you're in paradise. Like, wait, we got to where we want to be. And all of a sudden, the rug gets pulled out from under you.
That was our point. That's what we never understood is we were gone. We probably would have never come back. If they would have left us alone, we would have stayed gone. So now we're going to succeed in spite of what they did.
Yeah, and it's funny because some of it has been reignited because we're coming over here to Mobile County. We're starting to really take a lot of their agents. They're getting desperate, and they're offering like crazy incentives to retain and recruit, and we're just doing what we're doing and organically growing. And they're like, they're calling our agents and going and offering them like, come work here for a year for free. Like, we'll just let you keep everything you earn. Oh, and by the way,
they still don't go.
Yeah, and they still don't go. And then, you know, by the way, or before we hang up, what are they doing over there that we can duplicate? And they're literally saying, come show us what they're doing, and in return, you'll get a full year with, you know, 100%, you know, earnings. Wow.
I think that's what excites me the most.
Yeah,
is that it? You know, anybody can go and tell them what we're doing. But nobody can replicate the culture that is set within JWRE, and they'll never, ever be able to touch it. If you have the wrong people, or you have the people who are not servant-hearted and they don't live to any sort of value, you know, we'll tell you what it is. We'll tell you it's our culture. But until you have the people who can carry that out and actually mean it, it means nothing.
Well, we're just about to wrap this up. Thanks so much for sharing that wild story of your beginning. Agent 251 really has this kind of spy feel to it, too, because your beginning felt like, you know, a famous Hollywood kind of spy film. So thanks so much for sharing that. Everyone, thanks for listening. And Jason, Diane, thanks so much for coming in today.
Had a blast.
And all right, bye.
Thank you.
Well, that wraps up another Agent 251 podcast. Thanks so much for listening. You can find our show on iTunes, Stitcher, any place you get your podcast fix. We really appreciate the listening, and please share it with your friends. This show has been paid for and powered by JWRE, Jasonville Real Estate. You can find Jason, Diana, and the whole JWRE team on the internet and Facebook. And everybody, have a great and productive and happy weekend.